Previous episode, you got to see me be an idiot and talking birds. Let's get back to the Mid-Atlantic BDR. Gary, what do you think of section?
Oh, don't even start.
7 of the BTR.
It was fun, man.
Had a blast?
That one's good.
What was the name of that one we did today? It wasn't Poe's Patty. It was the.
Yeah. Flatbird something or whatever. I don't remember what it was called.
Was it hard?
No.
It was just big rocks.
Just rocks.
Rocks. Just rocks. And lots of rocks.
Yeah.
Fucking rocks everywhere.
Yeah. Too many rocks.
All right, we're ending the BDR at the Rusty Rail tonight. All the hotels are kind of full. We're going to have to move on to the Best Western. Can't camp. It's too cold. All right.
Cold as shit. Flat.
We had left the Rusty Rail Brewery and stayed in Lewisburg at the Best Western Country Cupboard. Now we had to head all the way back through Hartleton into the heart of the Pennsylvania game lands. That would be a great time for a map review. We've left Hartleton and we're currently going through the gap of Sheasley Run. And we're basically going to run the Sheasley Run all the way toward Lock Haven. You can see some snowflakes here and there, but since the camera doesn't pick them up very well, I'll just add some fake snow to give you a better idea what it looks like. Okay, back to the real snow. If you've figured out a way to record the audio of two SEMA 50s in a mesh network, drop me a note down below. We're still in Bald Eagle State Forest, but at this point we're almost 3/4 of the way through the BDR.
Oh, hell yeah, motorcycles are dangerous. I mean, goddamn, look at this fucking rolling death trap. I mean, my piss poor riding skills aside, this thing's overpowered, way underbraked, and it has the fine-tuned handling capabilities of a goddamn Walmart shopping cart. Shit, it could burst into flames at any minute, running or not.
Keep in mind that the temperatures are in the lower 40s, and it is switching back and forth between snow and rain. With the Gerbing heated jackets, we just want to get to the destination. We exited Bald Eagle State Forest just after noon. I passed a large building that looked kind of interesting. Google Maps said it was Restless Oaks Restaurant. We circled into the back parking lot to find three other adventure bikes parked in the back. We parked right beside him, and the waitress actually sat us next to him. We took off our many layers of clothes and ordered a hot chocolate. Gary got a coffee, I think, and then I ordered a chili. I did debate about having breakfast. Everyone was enjoying their food, and the building was pretty cool. The huge fireplace caught my eye. It had a nice fire going. I almost wished our table had been right in front of it. There's a lot of antiques in the rafters and walls, which were fun to look at and read. A lot of the pictures showed the history of logging in Lock Haven. Lock Haven began in 1833 as a timber town. The BDR continues through Woolwich, Pennsylvania. You pass by a large shut-down mill. This was once the home of America's oldest continuously operating mill that processed raw wool and weaved it for finished textiles. It closed in December 2018, not due to waning interest in the Made in the USA, but because the owners didn't want to invest in it. You can still find Woolrich.com importing a lot of things from China, making much larger margins and profit. Woolrich sells a few things with the Made in the USA, but they don't actually make anything themselves anymore. Reminds me of Craftsman or Coleman, just a marketing name with somebody else's product. Woolrich was once an iconic American brand. The Arctica parka was designed in the 70s for workers constructing the Alaskan pipeline, when temperatures were regularly below negative 40. My next trip to Lock Haven, I'd like to visit the Piper Aviation Museum. It's an old factory that's been abandoned. They since have moved. Piper's known for its Cub and a series of aircraft bearing Indian names, like Aztec, Cherokee, Cheyenne, Comanche, Navajo, and Pawnee. Piper Aircraft Corporation grew up to be the world's leading producer of general aviation aircraft. Well, if you haven't figured it out, my budget for this production is pretty low, so enjoy some crap music from Filmora.
Battery change complete. What are you talking to?
Thank you.
Our goal for today is still Cedar Run. Hey, look, it's the guys from Restless Oaks at lunch.